Welcome. In this video, we're going to introduce a digital oscilloscope from Instek. This is a mixed signal oscilloscope, as you can see right here. The numbers after that has a meaning. The 2000 means that it is a 2000 series, the 7 means that 70 MHz, and the 4 means that it has 4 analog channels, that you can see right here. The first thing that stands out is a large LCD display, which is 8 inches. There are a lot of buttons, but these can be familiar. The other buttons above them and near the screen are plus buttons because it is a digital oscilloscope. A nice thing to have is that you can set all the channels with the buttons and the coils above them. This is the power button. I'm going to press it and we'll see how long it takes to boot up. As you can see, it took quite some time, around 30 seconds. The clicking sound you heard was the relays, which is completely normal. I quickly set up an external generator to make signals that I could show you. I've put a square wave signal to channel 1 and a simple wave sine form to the second one. As you can see, I've set a 2 watt amplitude for the square signal and that I'm synchronizing to channel 1 and it's on a 1000 Hz. The screen shows channel 1 right now, and if I press this button, it will show channel 2 as well. You can see that the channel 2 is moving because we are synchronized to channel 1, but if I change that in the trigger menu, the square wave starts moving because there's 1 Hz difference between the two. I changed it back to synchronize to channel 1. So this little red arrow in the top middle shows the trigger position, which is one of the biggest advantages of a digital oscilloscope. The advantage is that we can also see the signals before the trigger event. With these knobs, you can adjust vertical position of the signals, but if you press it like it's written down, it will pop back in the middle. The scale knob helps measure the current voltage of the signal. Now, for the buttons of the top right corner, there is the auto set button, which is pretty useful function to start the measuring. But you have to work with it more to be more precise. With the run slash stop button, you can pause the wave flow. And with the single button, you can measure single things. I forgot to mention, but it also has a logic analyzer, which is a 16-digit digital input. I quickly turned the oscilloscope on its back because I wanted to show you that the device has two separate arbitrary waveform generators. I connected it with some cables, and after that I'll show you how to set it up. On the other side, it also has a USB type B and a LAN port. To set up the generator, you have to press the option button, then the AWG. After that, you'll see an output and the two generators options. At first, I'll show you how to set up generator 1. If you pressed it, you can simply select the first option that says waveform, where you can choose which one you want. We simply choose a sine waveform. We can change the frequency, the amplitude and even the offset if you want. I set up the generator to 1 kHz, 2 volts amplitude and 0 offset. On the second generator, I did the same thing, except I chose ramp waveform and I set the frequency 1 Hz higher and the amplitude 1 watt lower. After you're done, in the output menu you can turn the outputs on. You can calibrate the measuring probe. There are two things next to the USB-A port where you can save pictures of your work. This is a big advantage too. Back to the calibration, you have to put the ground to the lower one and the other one to the upper one. After that, you hope to see a nice square. In my case, my measuring probe was overcompensated. If you turn the screw too much with a screwdriver, it will become undercompensated. So you're looking for a perfectly compensated, beautiful square. Thank you for watching this video. It took a lot of our time, so we hope you like it. Oscilloscope.